rap has been mostly a place for African-American males to have their say. And it has gotten so big and so beautiful and so amazing. And sometimes it's really ugly.
I always thought about it as a working class person working every day. They want to relieve some stress. Here's the music to relieve some stress.
For a Southern artist to go national and to be on TV and to the Supreme Court, come on, man. You gotta respect that. Luke literally put his life on the line for this generation.
It was never a personal beef with this rapper and that rapper because all of us loved each other. It was personal between a few people.
I really hated that it had to happen that way. I would rather not exist in hip-hop and have Biggie and Pac alive today than me be sitting here talking about him dying.
Atlanta is its own mecca of music. It was bass music that everybody was bumping. It was the Edward J mixtapes. It was all about Kilo Ali. You heard the bass music, you heard that Atlanta music. It wasn't nothing like it.
A lot of major labels didn't understand the music, so they weren't really as quick to sign anybody from Memphis, you know. They was kind of nervous or scared till we started selling records, you know what I'm saying, independently. Then it was like, oh yeah, let's do a deal.
Got to the point to where our fan base started being, we went from statewide to regional. And that's when all the record companies started coming. But it was a crazy movement, man. We didn't think it was gonna blow up that fast.
Don't miss The Message, all new next Wednesday at 10. Only BET can give you the real story of how hip-hop changed life as we know it in The Message. A special four-part documentary event. Relive the highs.
The Message was a significant artistic event.
The lows.
We won for best group and they blew us.
The tragedies.
That beef just split the United States in half.
And the triumphs.
Barack Obama embraces hip-hop culture.
Narrated by the history makers of yesterday and today. Don't miss The Message. All new next Wednesday at 10.